mind bending to see the little tiger tail coming out the back of the CT.
Yeah. We just had a bear, an Indian bear, and they gave him radiation. Not at our zoo, they had to knock him out, take him to a regular human facility, and put him, for the radiation treatment. And it worked.
We had a son there, unfortunately, his passing. They were doing stem cell therapy. These guys, and probably you have girls. These guys are part of the Great Ape Project, part of the EVA initiative. The males have been trained to stand up for cardiac ultrasounds. And so they're getting baseline cardiac ultrasound starting as young as they can train them. Most male gorillas in captivity die of a cardiomyopathy. It's a thickening of the wall of the heart. There's some question of whether our diet is causing it or just that they need to be older than they would in the wild. But by the time they show symptoms, their heart has progressed to a point where it's difficult to treat. And so by following them as young men and having a baseline what their cardiac function is, you can intervene. In fact, I think one of the boys will be coming out in a while is already on heart meds, as you would give a human. Well, he's 22 years old, so he's a middle-aged man.
What's your life expectancy?
Well, I think if you live to be 40, it would be a really good life for a male. We have a 47-year-old male at our spark park who's still the Silverback leader. And last year, the year before, we lost our oldest female who was 64. Hi, her name is Jessica. Jessica is mother of gorilla boys. She's had six boys here at the San Diego Zoo. No girls.
We had
So he's checking out because he knows.
This is by two different fathers.
Oh, is that the dad over there?
Nice.
Here
you. Very nice. Have fun.